2008, with funding from the Australian Government's Avoidable Blindness Initiative, Vision 2020 Australia established the Global Consortium. The consortium approach has created a platform for collaboration, sharing of resources and knowledge. In turn, this has created an eye health approach that provides access to specialist expertise, creates common goals for the greater good, builds capacity of the members and reduces duplication of programs in country, resulting in massive savings to national health budgets and contributing towards the achievement of the Millennium Development Goals. Since then, 14 programs have been implemented in 7 countries across the Asia-Pacific region. These programs are strengthening national healthcare systems, providing sustainable, comprehensive, high-quality, equitable eye care for the future of the region.
In Cambodia, global consortium partners are working on programs focusing on developing infrastructure and human resources. Takeo Eye Hospital's capacity has been increased and services enhanced. In recognition of the importance of eye health to the Cambodian government and its people, vision centres have been established at the regional Kampot Hospital and in Kiri Vong. In these vision centres, eye tests are carried out, spectacles are dispensed and referrals are made, ensuring that eye health services are available in some of Cambodia's most remote areas. Among the many people whose lives are being transformed is Yat, a grandmother from Takeo province.
My name is Shreyhan. My grandmother is blind. She remembers my face but cries because she's never seen my baby brother Heap. I take her hand and lead her around the village to stop her from falling. She worries because she can't work in the fields anymore. I help her gather wood to cook her rice. She says she's a burden to our family. My father took her to the eye hospital, a long walk from our village. Her blindness and she could see again. She was so happy to see her grandson for the first time. She said now she can do the things to help herself and her family, and walk around the village and talk to her friends like she used to.
On behalf of Cambodian people, I would like to thank to government of Australia through the Avoidable Blindness Initiative with all the partners that we supported and help to the people of Cambodia. Yeah, I would like to thank you a lot. So welcome.
An Ling Seng was a general nurse from Kampot province in Cambodia. He wanted to train as a refractionist because he was seeing so much preventable vision loss amongst his people. His training at the Prea An Dong Hospital in Phnom Penh is being funded through the Avoidable Blindness Initiative. And when he finishes, he will use his skills to help people in his province see more clearly.
Before you see inside,
8-month-old baby Sokong has been brought to the hospital from a faraway province by his family. His mother, Choni, had noticed a problem with her baby's eyes and could see that he was very distressed. Sokong had cataracts and if left untreated, could lead to blindness. His cataracts were successfully removed, and after the operation, Anling Seng tested his eyes and made up glasses for him.
On behalf of the national program for eye health and myself as the coordinator for eye care activity in the country, I would like to express my greatest appreciation for the support of ABI for the eye care system development in this country.
In Samoa, global consortium partners are working through a local NGO to reduce childhood blindness, implementing a school screening program that detects vision impairment as early as possible. At the Puapa Primary School, of 11 children vision tested, 2 were found to have trachoma. Thanks to the vision screening program, these children can now be easily recognized and treated. Before this program, the prevalence of avoidable blindness was significantly higher, and many children's deteriorating eyesight went undetected until it was too late.
I think if Missy Whipper was found out in doing school screening, there is a big chance for him to recover his vision if we detected earlier.
By the time Missy Whipper was taken to the Tuasavi Eye Clinic, eye nurse Tazi Leo realized it was too late to do anything to save his eyesight and he would go blind.
There was already damage done to optic nerves of both of his eyes. So in my opinion as an eye care specialist, there is no eye medical treatment can be helped for him.
Missy Wepper's parents were worried that this meant there would be no future for their son. But thanks to Australian government funding, programs are being developed and put in place for those children whose eyesight is severely impaired, and Missy Wepper's future is looking much brighter. The programs fund things like paying for a teacher's aid. Laptop computers are made available and Braille is taught, so that children like Missy Whipper will be able to attend a regular high school and develop skills and qualifications that will enable them to lead full and productive lives.
I'm Missy Whipper's teacher aide. My role is to help him not only describing textbooks and other study materials into Braille, but also reading the contents of the blackboard whenever the teacher is using it, and to liaise with the family, staff members, and students where appropriate to ensure that Missy Weber's visual impairment is not a barrier to his full inclusion of his goals and aspirations.
Ong olila ko so swang le um fa ye onga onga mawa le sila asang a wipay ilunga sawal vali lumolonga kupupua ipi ole kalya kule pops
paftaye I na fai malanga mai Australia na susuani la wa onga ai mesia na fai ngal wenga senis male fai ya onga yape ngau wa onga ile kuak kal dua nga kuang bom mua nga wa onga yape ning lo mo wel umar mana
the vision screening program that we are working on wouldn't have been possible without the support and the assistance of the Australian government and Australian NGOs.
The two priorities that our government always places, education and health. And so we'd like to sort of reiterate our acknowledgement and thank you to the people of Australia for the help.
Yeah, you know, we'd like to thank the Australian government for stepping in and helping with the school screening and with the people like Missy Wepa. That assistance was very much appreciated, and I hope the Australian will keep assisting our young children for their future.
Results demonstrate that the Global Consortium's programs are working and are literally transforming people's lives. Children who once struggled to see can now go to school thanks to a pair of glasses. People who are blind can be supported to lead a better life. Men and women who were once blinded by cataracts can now see and contribute to their family and community, enabling them to lift themselves out of poverty.
By working to prevent avoidable blindness and improve eye care for people in the Asia Pacific, it is estimated that over 100 million people can have their vision improved or restored by 2020. This is an achievable goal, and Australia has the expertise and the commitment to make it happen. And there's quite a few people who are benefiting from the Global Consortium programs that have something to say.
Thank you, Australia!